go to the Lord in a word of prayer. You got a special prayer request tonight. You go, like, for that, pray for it. Slip your hand up. God takes them even his door. I'm real proud of this tonight. I want you to pray for us while we do this. They told me if next year, if I'm okay this year, I can have four words to say. Next year. You pray for Gary, he's my leader. Love y'all. Father, thank you and praise you. Being so good to us. Father, we pray tonight that you'll have everything done exactly the way it should be done. And Father, I pray for ones that may be in here that does not know you as Savior. If they don't know you, Lord, pierce that heart tonight.
Yes, God.
Let them see how good you are.
Yes, Jesus.
We'll thank you. We'll praise you in Jesus' name. All right.
Amen. All right. This means you go get in place, brother. Amen.
Okay. Okay. You give it to
us. Yeah, that's fine. I'll just lay it down. Okay.
In a small little town of Albemarle, North Carolina, Alton and Roger are gathering supplies in preparation for a cold night.
Yeah. Yeah, this is yours, mine. That one's yours, Black.
Yeah, it don't matter. It's the same thing.
I just don't know about this, Alton. I tell you, I mean, this town right here, this is the snootiest town I've ever seen. They treat us like we're trash. And you want to set up, well, we're going to sell our tools. That's all I got left, man.
You ain't got no money to go nowhere else.
Yeah, well, I'd like to blow this town. Yeah, here, watch this. Watch this. I guarantee you. Watch it.
Can I help you with anything?
I don't know that junk.
Junk?
Junk. You see what I'm saying? Blow this town. What we need.
No, man. There'll be somebody else coming.
Wasting our time, what we're doing.
I'll give it a chance. Man, we just got set up.
Here comes all that.
Yeah, that's...
What are you looking at?
Look at somebody that can get a job.
What, do you think I'm a bum or something? You don't know anything about me. What you carrying on down the street?
But you ain't getting none of my money, you bum.
I don't need your money. I'll show you who's a bum. That's what I'll do.
Hey, listen to you.
Hey, he started it.
Listen to you, going down the road this way.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know what you're
saying. We need to kill this.
It just got started. We might have enough after a while to buy some drink. We'll sit back and we'll
blow this town. What we need.
Oh, Lord. Lord, please give me the compassion and the guidance to talk to these young men. Lord, we know that not everybody is like just what they ran into. Lord, help me. Give me the compassion to talk to these men. Good afternoon, gentlemen.
Evening. How are you?
Doing good. How about y'all?
Yes. The things are slow.
I overheard some confrontation out here.
He's about to give it up. And there's nobody buying nothing.
We need to blow this down, what we need to do.
Let's give it a chance.
Well, let me just say a little bit of an encouragement. Not everybody is like him.
That's what I've been telling you.
Not everybody is like that. There's some good people in the world. Not everybody's like that.
Yeah, I'd like to see one.
You ain't give it long enough. Just hold on. You always was impatient.
Hey, when your friend, when he calms down, can you please talk to him?
Yeah, I'll try to talk to him. It's a job, but I've been working.
I'm afraid if he stays real heady like that, he's going to get in real trouble. I don't want that for y'all.
Yeah.
But look, we're going to be praying for y'all.
I appreciate it.
We got a place... Lighthouse Baptist down the road, and we got a gym, and we've got food, and we got blankets, a warm place to sleep, and y'all are welcome to go anytime and get off the streets. Please consider that.
That sounds good.
Hey, we got a nice building right here. This works for me.
Yeah,
I understand. But maybe on a really, really cold night, maybe you can get out of the cold. We got all the community that you would need there.
We got plenty of blankets.
Yeah, lady just dropped us off those last week. That real cold night, she felt sorry for us. She wanted us to have them warm blankets. But she said something about the church down the street, but I can't talk him into doing nothing.
Well, I'm gonna be praying for y'all.
Thank you.
All right, remember, Jesus loves y'all.
I'm trying to talk with you.
Yeah. You can go down there if you want to. I ain't going down there. I'm sorry. Hey, you know what? I got cold water here. I can get me a shave right here. Whatever you want to do out there. I ain't going to the truck.
Yeah, it's like what's this, shaving cold? Look here.
Well.
shave if you want to. It's too
I know,
cold.
But you know what? I don't know about this. I
didn't give us a chance.
Well, I know that. Look here. This right here ought to be worth $20 anyway.
Yeah, at least.
The following day after lunch, Alton and Roger come back to their spot where they are set up to sell their things.
That right there ought to be worth.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Hello, how are y'all?
All right,
how are you?
Oh, we're doing great. Just want to stop by and just say a few words like Jesus loves you.
Mm-hmm.
We'd like to invite you to our church too.
Mm-hmm.
That's what we're going
to do. I know.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
We ain't sold one thing.
Well, how long we've been? We ain't been here long.
Richard Glenn, let me introduce you to a couple guys that I met the other day. It was kind of an awkward situation with some things that was said by a bystander, but I really tried to encourage them about the church and that we had a place for them to sleep and we could offer them warm food.
It's nice to meet y'all too, gentlemen.
Yeah, you too.
We got a warm place to sleep. We got food.
You call that warm?
We just want to make sure you know that the invitation's still open. God bless y'all.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. God bless you. I'll try talking to him. He took half my blast while he was born.
Well, you know what? I
you put sales on this stuff.
All right, look here. This is mine.
I thought we was in 50-50.
Roger and Alton are hoping to sell things today and not have to take handouts for provisions that they need.
Trying to get my thing.
No,
they don't look like mine. They got rust on them. I use my tools.
That's $5.
I used to use them anyway. Let's say, good God, I'd be better.
Yeah.
Lost my job and everything else. That's why we sell them.
Yep. Oh, hey. Here comes somebody.
Yeah, I'm kidding.
I hope it's this one.
Me too.
How y'all doing?
How you doing?
All right. Didn't help you find anything or looking for anything in particular?
I like this.
That's
cool. That's nice.
I think it even works.
Hey, it does work.
Look at that.
Hit it again.
I like that.
Yeah.
How much?
Let's sell for $29.95.
$10
anyway.
Yeah, $10 would be good.
Okay.
Might better cut it off. That battery might go out. We ain't got no guarantee on them batteries.
Yeah, the batteries ain't included, you know. So.
But in your bucket?
Yeah, right there. That's right.
You see anything you like?
All you got $4.
We got some tools right here. I don't know what you like, but I mean that's a good pair of channel locks right there. Hey, $2 on that one.
$2.
I hate to sell them. I mean, you know, but
I give me four for it.
Give me four for it.
Yeah.
All right. That'd be good.
That sounds like a good deal.
Yeah, it's good right there.
All right.
That's $14. All right.
That's good.
Anything else?
No, I think that'd be good though.
Yeah, it worked good for you.
Just don't.
Yeah,
they already worked good.
Oh, you want the cutter, okay.
Yeah, I thought you wanted that.
Oh, you need those right there. They're about brand new right there.
I'll take these.
Okay.
These will work.
Yeah, they're good and sharp.
Sure did nothing else.
No. Just remember, God, Jesus love you.
What's that?
God, Jesus love you.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
We would love to have y'all at Lighthouse Baptist Church.
Down the street.
Right down the street, yes.
Yeah, maybe sometime, we'll see about it.
I'll see if I can talk to them, maybe.
Appreciate y'all stopping by, though.
You're welcome.
You too. Y'all have a nice day.
You too.
$14 right there.
That's dinner.
Yeah.
Oh, you ready? You want to pack up now?
No, I'm going to wait a little bit.
You want to stop at this market?
Oh, here's somebody.
Yeah, okay. Well, hey, how y'all doing?
Hey, all right. How you doing?
We're doing good. Just out about a little bit today. Kerrigan, you see anything you like?
Yeah.
What you thinking about?
Looks good.
Okay. How much you guys take for this?
What was it, $2?
$2.
Oh, $2?
It's okay. Warm, too.
All right. Are you collecting here in this bucket?
Yeah, that's
pretty good. Right there.
Okay. Right
in there. Yeah.
All right,
yeah.
We'll drop that in there.
I would like for you to have this.
This is for me?
Yes.
Did you draw this?
Yes.
You artist?
No.
Go to art school?
Look like you should.
Yeah.
Wow, that's good.
Yeah, you should draw too.
How old are you?
10.
Wow. What's your name, child?
Kerrigan.
Reminds me of when I used to draw some with my daughter. She's about your age. There's that John 3:16.
Yeah. I know John, but I don't know that 3:16.
I'm not sure.
That ain't the same John, I bet.
God loves you no matter what. That sounds like my daughter would do. I appreciate that. I really do.
Thank you.
Wow. I'll cherish this.
Well, thank y'all for this. And if you guys are free, come down to the church. We're just down the road at Lighthouse Baptist, okay? We'd love to have you.
Thanks for the invite.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
Lighthouse
Baptist
Church. Well,
again.
Have you noticed?
I like that.
The last two people that come by, Christian people.
Churchgoers.
Yeah, just Christian people, good people.
That's what you call them, Christian?
Yeah.
Well, that's right. My wife, she said she was a Christian. My daughter was a Christian. Well, you know, hey. That's what she reminded me of, my daughter.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, but anyway. I've been here for 3 weeks. You ain't asked me where I've been in 4 years.
Well, I kind of wait for you to just tell me.
Well, I mean, he always knows that. He was always nosy. Hey, let me tell you what. Well, yes, well, you was in school.
Yeah,
hey, look here. You remember Karen Lowder? She is a church girl. She's a pretty girl. Remember, she's real nice in school
all
the
time. Good to everybody.
She speak to everybody.
Yeah,
I know her. I know
her. Talk well about her.
Yeah. Talk to you. I'm telling you what, she's doing good. But anyway, hey, you know, I went in the Army for 4 years. You tried to talk me out of it. I didn't like it. I mean, that GI stuff, man, I'll tell you what. Now I ain't got no hair.
Yeah.
They didn't like my bike.
Yeah.
They all started to give me a hard time about my bike. I got a 450 Triumph. That thing worth a lot of money to me today. I got rid of it.
Good you got your heart again, didn't you?
Yeah, me and Muley used to ride. Remember Muley?
Yeah, Big Muley.
He's still living, ain't he?
No. He passed away with cancer.
Lock it on. But anyway, we was at a mall. Me and my buddy, Willie. I don't remember Willie. Remember Willie not? We was at a mall. I had an old pickup. We was having trouble with it. I saw Karen and her mama. I think it was that. She got a little sister named Anna or something like that. But anyway. But, yeah, I mean, I know Hannah, yeah, right. But anyway, we were down there, and I asked her if she knew who I was. She said, I know exactly who you are.
Yeah,
we got to talking. Hey, you know what she did? She gave me her phone number. She gave me her phone number.
You gave me her phone number?
Yeah, you never did get her phone number.
No,
I'm telling you what.
I ain't taking it hard as you get
the phone. Hey, you know what? You either got her or you ain't. That's what you always said.
But anyway. Everybody can't be handsome like you.
Hey, we started dating. I started going out with
her. I mean,
we did. Yeah, 6 months down the road, I popped a question to her. She said, "I need to wait a little bit." I said, "Well, you know I love you." She said, "I know that." And about 6 more months. It's been about a year we was dating. And I popped it to her again. She accepted. So we got married.
No, you didn't.
Yes, we did. Yes,
she married you.
Yes, sir. I miss her out.
I bet soon.
I do.
Well, where's she at now?
Well, I lost her childbirth, Mindy, my daughter. I remember her telling me about John 3:16 and Jesus loved me, and I never did go to church with her. I just kind of wish I had her now, you know, but Wendy told me the same thing.
Wendy?
Yeah, we used to draw together. She draws. So that's what that little girl reminded me of.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, where's Wendy?
She died with cancer at 11 years old. Last thing she told me, she said, Daddy, I'll see you in heaven if you accept Christ as your Savior. I don't know how to do that, Alfie. I know you gotta be good. I mean, I guess I ain't good.
I ain't neither one of us.
We just rocking the core.
I don't know how to guide you that way. If I can take you to a place, you got to have a paper from a judge to get in, though.
Yeah, I know. I've been in a few of them situations. Hey, look here. I told you my life story. Now, where you been 4 years? Yeah. I know. I heard some of it.
Yeah, all them motorcycle clubs.
I believe you've been in the big house too, haven't you?
Yeah, but you never found out something while I was there.
What's that?
Them bracelets they put on you.
Yeah.
I'm allergic to them.
I will be allergic. I've been in jail a couple times. I ain't been in the big house, but anyway.
Yeah.
Hey, look here. We got what we got to do on this right here. Hey, this is. I know this thing's really newer than what I thought it was. We ought to put $30 on it.
Yeah, it'd be a good price on it.
Alton and Roger is setting up more things to sell when Billy comes by and stops to look at Alton and Roger.
That's in good shape.
That must have been yours.
Hey, I ain't dealing with this. You got a problem.
Yeah.
Well, what's your problem?
I don't know. I came to apologize.
Apologize?
Yeah, I came to apologize for the way I talked to you the other day.
I ain't never had nobody apologize to me.
I had no right talking to y'all like that. You see, my wife, she died about a year ago. And I really miss her. I loved her so much. And when she died, I just got angry and I held a lot of grief in my heart. And I got bitter and cold. But I miss her. You know, my preacher, he's preached the last 2 weeks on love, kindness, and forgiveness. And God's told me, he said, you need to get rid of this if you want your joy back. I came to apologize. I had no right talking to you like that.
You believe that?
I know your pains, friend. I lost my wife and one girl. I know what it's like. What's your name?
Billy.
I'm Roger. This is Alton.
Yep.
And Billy, what do you do for a living? We try to sell. We're selling our tools.
Yeah, we've got to sell our tools. We ain't even got no transportation. No, we haven't sell all our tools.
I'm a contractor.
A contractor?
I own a lot of the buildings around here in the town.
The apartment buildings and stuff?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Yeah. I see you got your tools and all. Y'all got any carpet work?
That's all we've ever done, really.
That's what we got carpenter tools there, man.
What little bit we got left.
Yeah.
You know, I need a couple guys to do some work around the apartments I've got. Is that something y'all might be interested in?
I mean, we ain't gonna build no big house. We got some age on it.
No, just groundwork. You know, fixing a few odd end things.
What we're talking about?
We'll give you a company truck. Pay for your gas, expenses, have a furnished apartment, pretty good pay.
Wait, is this for real?
Yeah, man.
Man, it beats what we're doing now.
Yeah, when we start?
We start Monday morning.
Monday morning.
Wow.
I'll bring
Are you sure?
Yeah. If Y'all game. I need two good guys.
I'm game.
I'll bring the trucks.
Hey, man, we don't do dope. We don't drink stuff like that. I mean, we did years ago. We don't do that stuff. We just fell into hard times and stupid stuff. But we, you know what? We're leaving that behind. If you give us a chance, I promise we'll do good for you.
I'll tell you what. I'll come by in the morning. I'll bring the truck.
Monday morning?
We'll come by in the morning with the truck.
Bring oh, okay.
So we're back up.
Okay.
Start packing the stuff up, put the tools on the truck, and Monday morning we'll start the job. I'll carry you by and show you where apartments are.
Wow.
You hear that?
Yeah, really, I appreciate it. Yes, sir. We won't let you down.
We'll see you in the morning.
We'll show you what we can do.
You might want to save your tools, though. You might.
Yeah, we absolutely. Yeah, we're going to be here.
Hey, we're putting them bows on in our new apartment.
I know. Man, can you believe it?
We can keep ours.
Golly. Hey, that preacher's coming by. Ain't it Friday tomorrow?
Friday,
they're bringing us food tomorrow.
Man, Friday. Food, truck, job.
Don't that guy go to his church? Is that the same one?
Yeah, okay.
That's right. Well, here, look. Hey, we got to keep up what we sold then. So, all right, we sold the land.
Yeah.
Pound.
Yeah.
Blanket. And we got the tools here. Okay, here we go.
Alton and Roger are excited about the job Billy gave them. They are putting the stuff together when the church folks come by.
Hello, how are y'all doing today?
Hey, all right. How y'all doing? Boy, something smells good.
We got you some nice warm barbecue, enough to last for a good while.
Wow. Thank you. Thank you.
All right, look at all this food coming in.
Look at her.
Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank y'all. What was your name again?
Kerrigan.
You gave me something nice the other day, and I used to be an artist years ago before I become a bum, but it was kind of my first love, and then I started doing carpentry work. But we did some copies of this. That's a painting I did. I want you to have that.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Praise the Lord.
You got just a minute?
Yeah.
Kerrigan, when you gave me this, it reminded me of my daughter. She's in heaven, my wife's in heaven. And this is kind of all the stuff she drew. Yeah, I'm sorry. Get a little emotional when I think about them, but anyway, got a lot of bad things in my life since they've been gone. I've been just hurting my heart. Went the wrong way and did stupid stuff. Do you think Jesus really loves me?
Yes.
And Alton, too?
Anybody can be saved by God.
Both of us?
Yes.
You think He'd save us?
praise the Lord. What a true message that is.
They want to be saved.
They do?
Yeah.
Roger and Alton?
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. Thank you. All right. Let's go talk to them, brother.
Good.
Amen. Let's go share with them how they can become a Christian and know the Lord.
You want to be saved. I can show you the best decision you ever made.
Amen.
Amen. You'll make Him the Lord of your life tonight. And don't leave without knowing Him. Because He is the greatest gift that you'll ever receive. There's a scripture that's very dear to my heart. And it's in John 6 and verse 37. And Jesus spoke these words. He says, "For all that the Father giveth me shall come to me. And him that cometh to me I will in no wise cast out." Say amen right there. It don't matter what your past is, what you've done. There's forgiveness in the blood of Jesus. Stand to your feet tonight with me. While the song is still playing softly tonight, do you need Jesus? Do you know Him as your Savior? Every head bowed and eye closed. Let's just do inventory tonight. Only you know your heart. I don't know your heart, but the Lord Jesus does. He knows our hearts. Are you here tonight and say, "Preacher, I know without a shadow of a doubt that Jesus lives in my heart"? Will you slip your hand up and right back down? Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I wonder if there'd be one to say, "Preacher, I don't know that for sure. I don't know that Jesus lives in my heart." Will you slip your hand up for prayer tonight? I'm not coming to you, but I just simply want to pray for you tonight. Would there be one to say, "I don't know that of a surety"? Everybody say, praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. Look up tonight. Amen. What a powerful message in this program that the Lord actually put on Roger's heart. Amen. And it really shares a couple things with us, that God loves anybody. And that anybody can fall on hard times. But yet, be faithful in our witness to God. Amen. Be faithful, because we may not know what that person is going through, but let's try to share the love of Jesus with everybody. Amen. And as these two men, they began to see the compassion of God's people and Christians, it began to melt their hearts. And that's really how you win a person to Christ. You have to win that person over to you as a friendship or whatever. Not partake in what they do, but then they see something special. They see something different about us. The Bible says that we are the light of the world. We're the salt of the earth. Amen. So be inspired by this, that that Jesus, he died for all men. Amen. For whosoever will. Amen. Praise the Lord for that. Preacher.
Anybody in this room deserves help? It was me.
Yes.
Me too.
Me too, brother.
And you know what? I have no doubt in my mind, if I'd have been the only one here when he died for me, he still died for me.
Yep.
We're all precious in his sight.
Amen.
Yes, we are.
And I thank God. I'll tell you, Roger, it wasn't easy to finish this play, that was it. Mm-hmm. The devil fought this thing from the very beginning. So I know when the devil fights it, something good's going to happen.
Amen.
I beg you, if you're saved today, fall back in love with Jesus.
Amen. Yes.
You know, you can know him, but you cannot know him. Is a difference. Yeah. You can know him by name, but you need to know him by deed.
Yeah.
Amen.
What he does for you, what you can do for him. Amen. We love you, church.
Amen. Yes. Thank you for visiting with us tonight. Amen.
Yeah, we're gonna.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
We're gonna be doing this play again. I know a lot of plays were done tonight, but didn't have no choice because of the way the dates fell. And there's a lot of people want to see this play. I know we're a few in numbers tonight, but that's okay. It touched all our hearts. And so we'll be doing it the 7th on the Sunday night, January. So just get the word out. Come back and see it again. Amen. And bring somebody with you. But, here's the thing about it. Love led me to Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
And it was still a lot of people. I think about the first one with my mother. She was a portrait of grace. So don't forget about that. When you go out in the marketplace tomorrow, when you go to work, when you get wherever you're at, think about how much he loves you. And I'm going to tell you something. God's in the loving and the forgiving business. And that's
Amen.
What we need.
Yes, he is. Amen. Praise the Lord, brother.
If you want to see it again, you've seen it one time, say you don't want to come back and see it again, but I guarantee you can come back and it'll be a different show.
Yeah.
Well, when Roger got saved during practice, they called me Rocket Man. I about left here.
You about left here, I'm telling you.
That's right. Yeah, it'll probably be a little different script next time. We just kind of play off each other.
Yeah, we do.
And we didn't memorize all them lines, believe me. Amen.
They're going to give me three words to say next time.
Yeah, we might give you four.
But we got several visitors. Thank you for being here. Church members, thank you for being here. And Michelle says there's more fruit bags back there. So even if you got one this morning, you can have another one. Amen. So make sure our visitors get one. But there's fruit bags, and somebody can get the lights for us. And preacher, you want to pray for us?
Yeah, let's do it.
And dismiss.
Let's go to the word of prayer.